One thing I really learned at NASA is that that's one of the first things you have to know how to do is come up with a really catchy acronym for whatever you're doing. One of the best ones we came up with was BIRRA, B-I-R-R-A, and it stands for Biologically Inspired Radiation Reflecting Ablator. BIRRA is, of course, the Italian word for beer, and we were using diatoms in our research, and diatoms are used to filter beer. And I was just amused to see if I could actually get BIRRA into the NASA time card system, and I did. My name is Sylvia Johnson. I'm a material scientist, and I work at NASA. I grew up in Australia, in Sydney, actually, and I went to a girls' high school, as was common. Wanting to study science and math at a higher level required a little bit of persuasion of the teachers, but in the end, once the teachers realized that some of us were very much interested in doing, say, a higher level chemistry, that they came and taught us at lunchtime and after school, just to make it possible. We got into quite a lot of trouble in school for setting the lab bench on fire and not reading the instructions. And that is something that I've tried to remember, read the instructions first. Then when I was in school, actually in high school, then there was the first moon landing. A lot of effort was made to make sure that everybody could actually watch this on TV. Now, of course, when you're a teenage girl in Australia, you don't actually think that you're going to end up in America working for NASA. Probably not really on the horizon. But I went to university. I became a ceramic engineer. I was the first woman to graduate from the full-time program. It combines, you know, physics and chemistry and geology and a whole bunch of other sciences and disciplines. And there's also sort of an art to it, apart from the fact that, of course, ceramics are extremely useful materials. There's all kinds of ways of processing materials which are actually very, very similar to things that you might do actually even in the kitchen, or even, in fact, sewing and other what we might call domestic arts and crafts. Back when I grew up, we, as girls, had to learn all of these things, and it turns out that a lot of them have turned out to be quite useful for me. Not everything works. Experiments don't work, proposals don't get funded, reviews go poorly, you can't answer a question, you have no clue what to do next, and your great idea turns out to be a complete bust. But you can learn from it. And the idea is not to go down that line again and to remember, what did I do wrong last time, or why didn't it work? Things might still go wrong, but things go wrong for everybody. Nobody has a perfectly linear trajectory with everything going right. I've talked to lots of young women, and I get one question. There's always the first question. We always know what it's going to be. And it's, how do you balance having a family and a career? And the answer is, you do, and you can, and you should not have children just because of a career. Make your own choice on children for whatever reasons you want, but don't think you can't have them. You just have to think of some creative ways of getting them looked after, and your children can turn out just great. The advice I'd give to young people is that you really must think about the things that you're interested in, but then do the job right and be honest in what you're doing. Be honest in your research and your dealings with other people. And I think being good and kind and thoughtful to other people, even though people might not return that to you, at least at the end of the day, you'll feel fine and you'll sleep well.